A real passion of mine has been trying to connect fitness with healthcare. I've certainly seen this in my practice, how patients who do regular exercise are so much healthier. And you know, they need less medication, they're less likely to become depressed, less likely to develop heart disease and other chronic diseases.
Many years ago now, before I came, Dr. Salas encouraged our leadership to assess physical activity. We coined it the exercise vital sign. At every outpatient visit, our patients or our members are asked about their physical activity.
We had huge numbers of patients where we had exercise data and we could really accurately measure their health outcomes, including how they did with COVID.
People who had contracted COVID and who were physically active before COVID had lower risk of becoming hospitalized, having some kind of a deteriorating effect in the hospital and or dying.
Every one of those risk factors were dramatically improved if people would exercise regularly.
But no one's really been able to look at how much physical activity do you need for this to work? And is it consistent across different demographic subgroups?
Were males and females equally affected? Were ethnic minorities, did they see the same benefits? Did people who had various chronic diseases, people who were obese or overweight, did they get the same benefit, the same protective effect of exercise? That's really what this study helped to answer, that question.
And we found, at each one of those stair steps, compared with those who are always inactive, there was a reduced risk of being hospitalized, reduced risk of an ICU encounter, and reduced risk of death. We call that a dose-response relationship, that the more you get, the better the outcome is. And we found that pretty much consistently, again, across all these demographic subgroups.
We ask patients if they smoke. We weigh them, we measure their height so we can record their BMI. We talk to them about other risky behaviors, from alcohol to drugs. Why do we not include exercise in that list of things we ask about?
The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention has included being physically inactive as one of the major risk factors for adverse COVID outcomes.
It's a free medication. In my mind, exercise is a medicine that I need to prescribe to all my patients. And every time, if they have a chronic disease or they're at risk for a chronic disease, that exercise helps.
As a scientist, I'm more interested in the behavior, trying to encourage individuals to be physically active. And we really need to look at the environments in which we live, particularly in our underserved areas, that they need more parks, safe streets, they need sidewalks.
How do I fit physical activity into my daily routine? That's the biggest challenge. We've been both pushing this for heart disease, for diabetes, for depression. We need to include the exercise piece in that. It's not just about the medications.